When it comes to the issue of Salah, quite often we see that no matter how hard we try to keep the row straight, and this is not to actually belittle anybody because every one of us are in it together, okay? What we notice is that the phenomena is that we're keeping the row straight by the front, okay? This is amongst ourselves and we are having the V shape, okay? And to a degree when we are standing, the feet goes this way, both ways, like spreading the top bit and going like the penguin shape, okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us the feet to be straight when we are standing on the row, okay? Of course, from the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to have differences as well. Someone would be quite tall, the other one would be quite short, someone's feet would be quite bigger than the other ones. Okay, this is from the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is only Allah who does that. Okay, so when it comes to straightening the row, make sure that always it is straightened from the back rather than from the front. Okay, from the back of your feet.
Heels.
This way.
The heels.
Yes, all the way to the back. So when that is straight, then the back of the musalli, those who are praying, it is straight. And that is actually one of the signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us victory. Only if the row, when it comes to taswiyat al-sufuf, the row to be equal from the back. And when we're standing, as if we are ready. Okay, we are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And quite frankly speaking, when we're standing, when the standing is not equal, when the feet are not from the back straight and they are not closed as much as it should be, whereas we're trying from the three toes this way, whereas it should be as close as possible from the back, right? So if that is the case, that we see the gap will not be there anymore. Even with the V-shape, when we're standing, we are having shaitan amongst ourselves, actually. Like while we're standing, unfortunate reality. I know that the toes are touching each other. What do you call that, the youngest? Is it the edit? What do you call that? Is there any name for the pink toe? Pinky toe, yeah. Pinky toe, yeah. So even when you touch the pinky toe, you are still having that gap, the triangular gap for the shaitan. No matter how hard you try to say that, okay, we don't have gap because the pinky toes are touching each other, still shaitan is there. So let's try to eliminate that and let's try to revive the sunnah. Let's look at how Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam instructed the sahaba. Let's look at the ahadith. After the Kitab al-Tahara, in any book of fiqh, you will see that there is Kitab al-Salah. Let's look at those ahadith relevant to the Salah. Okay? And every one of us need to actually acquire that knowledge, acquire that information. Okay? The more we are into that, the more we try our best, the better our life will become. The better we will do in our salawat, the more perfect it will become. Okay, why? Because we need that. And it is only the salah, every nitty-gritty thing within the salah, that will be actually talking for us when we are in our graves, when we are in our kubur. And that is our ultimate place to go to before we go to either Jannah or Jahannam. Okay, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be amongst the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through his aqwal, through his a'mal, through his approvals, through his verbal statement to be followed, through his actions that need to be followed, as well as the approvals of Rasulullah that need to be followed. Hada wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. غُرَبًا
غربا غربا.